Does your car have some body damage? Stop by Lakeside Auto Body, where we can take care of all your auto body needs. Whether it is dent removal or hail damage, they can fix it. They also have a wide variety of paints to choose from for partial or full body paints. You can find us at Hettinger 103 Highway 8 South, North Dakota 58639, or call us at 701-567-4380.
Discover the Adams County Library, where adventure meets relaxation. Beyond books and movies, we offer the incredible Recreation Library, which is absolutely free to the public. Explore serene waters with kayaks and paddleboards. Enjoy quality family time with disc golf, bikes, and kites. Experience thrilling activities like tennis, pickleball, and spikeball. Unlock a world of not only recreation, but excitement here at the Adams County Library.
Attention, coaches, players, and fans. Here is a message from Nighthawk Nation.
We as Nighthawks expect you to follow these simple expectations.
Make sure to practice good sportsmanship. Please be respectful to all. Positive cheering goes a long way. And remember, we are just kids.
We all make mistakes.
To our coaches, remember to always encourage your players.
We all make mistakes, so for the players to stay focused on the game, as coaches, you should always talk positively to your players.
And remember to relax, let the players play, and the refs ref.
To all players,
leave a positive imprint on and off the field, court, mat, and track.
Work hard, play your role, and most importantly, have fun. It's just a game.
Fans, we need to see you at our sporting events because without you, there is no excitement.
To make sure you stay at our games, please refrain from using bad language, no yelling at refs, coaches, and players.
Make your yelling positive because you can't cheer if you're not here. So remember, be positive.
As a West River doctor, we provide care for patients of all ages, from newborns and toddlers to tweens and teens. Whether your children need routine checkups or specialized care, our experience and compassion are here to support their growth. Because even though they may be small, their health is of utmost importance. I'm a West River physician dedicated to the health of your family and our rural communities.
Hawk Talk is the official podcast of Hettinger Public School, where we keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insight to school board meetings, and dive deep into the educational experience our school provides for the students, parents, and tight-knit community. Take a minute to enjoy a clip from our most recent episode.
All right, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Hawk Talk. Today I have with me Sheriff Jordan Fisher. Jordan's been here for the last 2 years, been a heavy involvement with obviously law enforcement, but especially our school and our community, having a heavy hand on taking care of drugs in our local area. And I just want to thank Jordan for coming in and talking to us today about the services that you provide, not only in our community, but also how that affects our kids here at the school. So thank you very much for coming in.
Yeah, no, thank you for having me, Jordan. I think this is a great platform for us to be able to kind of have a different dynamic. You know, we try to get into the paper as much as we can and do some articles there and go on KNDC, but this is just another form of media that I think is just fantastic for this community to have. So thank you for having me on.
Awesome. Thank you so much, man. So the first question that I just kind of want to get out of the gate is obviously just kind of the history, you know, where you came from and how we got to here, to this current moment. But before we get here, though, you just got back from kind of some unplanned time off.
Yeah.
So what happened? What did some medical stuff, or are you doing all right?
Yeah. So it was December 19th. So just before Christmas, I ended up having to go into the hospital, have my appendix removed.
And oh, fun. Oh, that's so fun.
Yeah, being a little stubborn, I was like, man, I think I just got a little sick. You know, I have, you know, three kids, and I was like, man, maybe I just have like a little bit of a stomach bug. And no, it ended up being appendicitis. So went in and had to get that removed, and doing really good now. The hospital staff, the nurses, and give a shout out to Dr. Andreas up there, the surgeon. She did an awesome job. So I'm feeling really good now. I'm back out on patrol and on duty, and sitting at home for 6 weeks kind of started driving
me nuts. Was kind of a recovery process too. You couldn't just jump back into it, because there's, I'm sure, weight restrictions and the whole slew of things that you can and also cannot do.
It was tough, man. That 6 weeks, just being, you can only watch so much Netflix, right? So
you can only keep your mind so busy, you want to go and do things. So glad to have you back, glad to see you back in uniform and stuff. So great to have you here. So let's go into the history. So how did we get to Sheriff at Hettinger? Where did that all start? Where are you from? How did you go, you know, into this field? All of that.
Sure. So originally I'm from Bowman, and lived there all the way up until I was a junior in high school. Moved down to Rapid City and lived with my dad the last 2 years of high school down there. And while I was in Rapid City, the school systems down there have what's called an SRO, or a school resource officer. They're an actual licensed peace officer. They work for the, you know, Rapid City Police Department, but they end up coming to the school, and they're there throughout the day, Monday through Friday, during normal school hours. And their job really is to, you know, make sure that kids are safe first and foremost. But they also kind of act like a counselor in a way. And so with me going to school down there, I've always been interested in law enforcement. That was also, that was always a career path that was always interesting to me. When I was in sixth grade, I still taught to my sixth grade teacher from Bowman, and we had to write this little project about where we saw ourselves when we were grown-ups, right? And on there, I put down that I was going to play football for NDSU, and that I was going to go and I was going to be an undercover DEA agent. So I didn't play football for NDSU, and I didn't go into the DEA, but, you know.
But the trajectory is similar.
Correct.
Similar.
Yeah. So sixth grade, I'd say, is kind of when I started having you know, an interest in law enforcement. And I think a lot of that has to come down to Will Smith and movie Bad Boys, you know, because I was like, man, I gotta drive like a Ferrari, and like, you know, I gotta wear like a, you know, like Miami Vice stuff, right? Every sixth grade boy's dream, man, is to drive a Ferrari around and go
yeah, be the coolest guy on the block. That's of course it.
And so you know, did that, and then went down to Rapid, got to really become pretty close to my SRO. He was a really cool guy. I'd go into his office during study hall period, and we would just talk about law enforcement. And yeah, from there, he suggested that one of his really good friends was a deputy sheriff for the Pennington County Sheriff's Office. He's like, hey, if your dad will sign off on a permission slip for you, you can start going on ride-alongs on weekends. They have what's called an explorer program down there. And so if you're in high school, you can actually start, you know, going on ride-alongs with officers. You can hang out at the department and really see what law enforcement has to offer as far as a career. And as soon as I did that, the first ride-along that I went on, he ended up chasing a guy down and arrested him. And I was like, that's for me, man.
That was it. It was that moment, and you were like, I'm in.
I mean, the guy was the guy had a bunch of meth on him, and he took off on a traffic stop, and he got out of the traffic stop. He took off on foot. I saw the deputy chase him down and arrest him, and you know, pulled a whole bunch of meth off of him, and he's like, this is why we do what we do, to keep this community safe. And from there, I was like, this is for me.
So you mean you really, you build. Now, if you enjoyed that conversation and would like to hear the rest of it, you can go and search for Hawk Talk HPS on Apple Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, and of course, our YouTube channel. Now on to the rest of our broadcast.
The HPS Stream Team is a school-to-work program in which students in grades 7 through 12 gain real-world experience while learning about the basics of live broadcasting and providing a service to our community. Now, let us take a moment to meet one of our members who help us make this possible.
Hey everybody, thank you very much for tuning in to the Streamer Spotlight, a portion where we highlight our streamers that are behind the cameras, behind the mics, behind the laptops, making these broadcasts a reality. Today we have Robert Larson in with us today. Robert, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Robert has been actually done one of these before, but it's been quite a while, so we thought we would kind of refresh it up and kind of give a new version of it. But Robert, thank you very much for coming in. For those who haven't seen one of these before, why don't you introduce yourself? You know, how old are you, your hobbies, your interests, all that stuff.
I'm Robert Larson. I am 17 years old. I am a junior currently. And some of my hobbies are, like, for example, I really enjoy just gaming. I watch a lot of YouTube, watch quite a bit of, like, shows and movies, and especially anime. And I really enjoy video editing, which most people don't.
Gotcha.
Yep. Yeah, I find it really therapeutic for some reason.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I'm a really big, like, music guy, and I have a whole list of hobbies, just things that I enjoy.
Awesome. Fantastic. So a lot in that media realm that you're really, really interested in. And you've been on the stream team for 2 years now?
Yeah, 2 years.
Coming up on the third year this fall. So, I mean, you've been around for quite a while. What do you like about the stream team? What's some of your favorite things?
Probably my biggest thing is just, like, it definitely feels like a community.
Yes, very, very much so. Where you kind of have a group of your peers that are kind of either like-minded or similar interests, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Gotcha.
Because, like, you know, we have a stream team chat on Teams, and we have a serious one, but also more of a funnies one. And there is a whole culture there.
Yep, absolutely. It kind of allows the students to kind of build that bond, kind of that trust amongst each other.
Be themselves.
Absolutely. So not only with that, too, other things with the stream team that Robert's been doing, because one of the things we like to do with the streamer spotlight is kind of not only introduce you to who they are, but also kind of show what they've done for the program as well. And Robert's one of our stream team leaders. He has a diamond category in all three, or he has a diamond badge for all three categories, which is microphone, which is your commentating,
producer, and cameraman.
And cameraman. He has diamond level, which is our highest level of competency that you can reach. And by doing that, it made him a stream team leader. So Robert has not only provided a lot of good service for the stream team, but he also has new responsibilities that come with it. So whenever we make changes or policy changes to the stream team, those stream team leaders get together and they get to help decide what the future of the stream team is going to look like and how that impacts the rest of the students who are part of the program. And Robert, it's been always a helping hand and always super helpful with all that. So thank you very much, Robert, for doing that.
I'm very passionate about this.
Yeah.
It's something absolutely that I do genuinely care about.
Absolutely. And, you know, another thing, and I've shared it last time, but I do have to share it again, is if another fun note for Robert is he does all the different jobs, but the main one that he does the most is commentary. And commentary for Robert, he loves to commentate the youth games. So, for example, all of our elementary streams, they have typically a lower viewage. But what Robert does is he's going to take basically an elementary basketball game or whatever type of game and make it feel like it's the NBA finals for what's happening on the court. And it just makes it really fun. Sometimes it's kind of funny, but it's super engaging. So he's coming at a very high level for something that seems to be a little bit more fun. It's really, really enjoyable to watch. So if you're ever bored, go onto the Stream Team YouTube channel and take a look at some of the elementary streams that we've done in the past. So
I really enjoy making the stakes unnecessarily high.
That's what makes it fun to watch, though. That's, like, the cool thing is that it adds value to the stream that you're watching and it makes it a little bit more fun. Absolutely. Well, anywho, that's pretty much the end of our stream team spotlight. Robert, any final words that you wanted to mention before we sign off?
Not much. Just thanks for watching.
Awesome.
Continue supporting the stream team.
Thanks.
Please and thank you.
The Hedinger Chamber of Commerce is a local business that supports other businesses in the Hedinger community. Their goal is to promote businesses and sponsor events in hope of attracting people to Hedinger while getting the community more involved. If you have questions about starting your business, an event, or want to find out more about the chamber, contact us at 701-567-2531 or visit us at 120 South Main Street.
Dakota Western Bank, your trusting partner since 1910, serving Hedinger, North Dakota, for personal banking with checking, savings, and auto loans for businesses in agriculture. We offer tailored services and digital solutions. Discover online banking applications and mobile options. This is our website for locations, hours, and career opportunities. Dakota Western Bank, where banking meets community, proudly serving Hedinger, North Dakota.
Need a place to keep your cash safe and secure? Come on down to Dakota Plains Federal Credit Union. We can get you your cash fast with our drive-through, which is open from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., or you could come into the lobby, which is open from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. We've been serving the community since 1992, and we are located at 221 South Main Street. You can contact us at 701-567-2153.
Take the next minute to learn about some upcoming reminders and events for Hettinger Public School and the Hettinger community.
West River has been serving our community for over 40 years. Our agents are here to help you get your home, auto, farm, ranch, business, health, and crop insurance. We are located in the lower level of Dakota Western Bank. Swing by at 603 Adams Avenue or call us at 701-567-9378.
At Ag Pro Machine, we provide quality work and full-time service for ag and automotive equipment. We also have a large selection of parts and tools for your automotive and ag equipment. Call at 701-567-7500. Or you can also stop by east of Hettinger along Highway 12.
Graphic Addict specializes in embroidery, screen printing, direct-to-garment printing, along with expert video and audio digitalization. Enjoy complimentary popcorn and explore over 50 flavors of delightful jelly beans when you visit. Don't miss out on gearing up for the upcoming sports seasons with our exclusive Nighthawk collection. Drop by Graphic Addict or call us at 567-3161 to discover the perfect fit for your style and needs.
Here at Kennedy's, we provide fresh goods and groceries for all your daily needs, ranging from our special selection of fruits and vegetables to our specially created delis and bakeries. Find us on 200 North Main Street or call us at 701-567-2404 to place an order.
Big deal with that subscribe button. It's not just for following our YouTube channel. It signifies much more. When you subscribe, you become a part of the HPS Stream Team, proudly supporting our vibrant program led by our students. Your subscription is a powerful statement, creating a positive ripple effect across our community and beyond. And don't forget, liking this video also sends a clear message to the students working this broadcast. It's a way to appreciate their hard work and motivates them to produce high-quality broadcasts. friend. Show your support. Like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.
Welcome to West River Vet Clinic. Here, we aren't just your pet's healthcare provider, we're their second family. Our awesome vets offer everything from checkups to surgery. Plus, we've got great grooming. Here, we are big on preventative care to keep your furry friends happy and healthy. We also ensure a stress-free environment for both pets and their owners. For our services, you can visit westrivervet.com. You can find us at 203 US Highway 12 East or call us at 701-567-4333.
The HPS Upload is a weekly broadcast of school news put on by the 7 through 12 video production class that provides coverage of recent events, sports, weather, and news stories. Now, let's take a look at the story from this week.
Exciting developments are underway at HPS as teachers lead a groundbreaking transformation in STEM education. With a forward-thinking approach, they've infused our school's STEM lab with state-of-the-art technology. Join me as I dive into the insights of teachers spearheading this initiative and hear firsthand from a student benefiting from these advancements.
How did we get all this of this new equipment in the STEM lab?
We asked the JCs for some money. Ms. Block and I have been writing some grants, and Mr. Siemens set aside a little bit of money that we are using for a couple of the different things that we got. So.
What are your thoughts on the new interactive board in the STEM lab?
I am very excited about it. We just bought it. We spent a lot of time picking out the one that would work the best. And I've played with it quite a bit, and I'm really excited, and I hope a lot of teachers start using it because it's pretty cool.
Have you used a 3D printer for anything lately?
Not lately, because it's kind of being a stinker and I gotta get it fixed, but I've done quite a few things. We did elements with the sixth grade. The first grade made little cookie cutters, and so I'm in the middle of printing those. So all kinds of different things.
I also heard that there were Lego robotics in this classroom. What's that about?
Yes, so a couple of years ago, the school invested a lot of money in three different levels of Lego robotics. There's some for the high school, those are the black kits. The yellow kits are for my age, so like fifth grade through seventh grade, eighth grade. And then there's the little blue kits for the lower elementary to use, and they're basically an introduction to coding and robotics and stuff like that. So they have like a little motor and hub and stuff like that, and then you just design it how you want, and then you code it to do exactly what you want it to do. So they're really cool.
Is there anything else you would like to add?
We are working really hard on getting this room ready, and it definitely still looks old school and stuff like that, but it's taken a lot of hours to get this place cleaned up, and we're really excited to see where it's going to go.
Have you ever used a 3D printer?
Yes, I have.
What have you used it for?
Like 3D printing minifigures and mostly just cool stuff.
Have you ever done Lego robotics?
Yes, I have.
When'd you do it?
We had to do it in sixth grade, and we just had to make things move.
How did you like all of this?
It was okay. Most of it, I liked 3D printing and the VR more. I wasn't the biggest fan of Lego robotics.
What will you be doing with VR in the classroom?
So our hope for VR is that we will eventually expand it and use it to train on our drone program. We right now are just using it to train the kids so they get used to it. Some kids have experienced it with home systems or other systems at like arcades, but most of our kids haven't seen it. So we're just getting them used to seeing what it can do, taking a look deep in the body, different places on the earth that they can go and the capabilities. And then again, soon, hopefully, we'll be able to do a virtual drone flight so we don't turn our drones into catastrophes. In real life, you can crash many times virtually with no problem.
Aside of VR, Lego robotics, and 3D printing, what other science activities happen in this classroom?
So as I said, we have a drones program that the high school is doing right now. This room is available for any use for any class, K-12. They just have to sign it out. We have, like you said, 3D printing. We have electronics kits. We have microscopes. We have building opportunities for when we work with the elementary, the STEM class works with them, and we'll be making catapults and different things. So the The options are pretty limitless. It's up to the creativity of the teacher.
As we conclude, let's applaud the pioneering spirit of HPS teachers in enhancing STEM education through advanced technology. Join us next time as we dive deeper into their inspiring journey of innovation.
Grand River Honey is a family-run business that's been making honey in both North and South Dakota and selling it to customers for over 30 years. We make several pounds of honey seasonally, all 100% raw and natural. This includes both clover and creamed honey. If you want some honey, call 701-567-3439, go to dakotahoney.com, or take a right after the railroad tracks on Country Club Road, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639.
Here at The Gutter, we provide a variety of food and entertainment. Make sure to enjoy bowling, pool, VR, table tennis, air hockey, and much more while we prepare your order. We have pizza, burgers, fries, dessert, drinks, and much more. You can find us by taking a left at the end of Main Street or call us at 701-567-6749.
KB Jewelers is not only a jewelry store, but they also contain a lot of other great things such as trophies, books, holiday decor, and more. When you're looking for gifts for family, friends, or if you want to look at some cool things, come on down. They're located on 206 South Main Street, Hettinger, North Dakota. You can contact them on their number 701-567-2358. They're open from 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. from Monday to Saturday each week. Come visit.
Welcome to the Peacock Mercantile.
We have been serving you since 2018. You can get baked goods like cookies, muffins, and pies. You can also get caffeinated beverages and non-caffeinated beverages. The Peacock is a nice place to socialize and meet new people. The Peacock also has refreshments like hot and cold coffee and smoothies. We are located at 213 South, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639. You can reach us at 701-637-0102. Again, that was 701-637-0102.
A better way of life is better days off and better nights in. Better hellos. And better goodbyes. With locally approved, financed, and serviced home loans, Gate City Bank makes buying a home simple. Welcome home. Gate City Bank, for a better way of life.
Does your car have some body damage? Stop by Lakeside Auto Body, where we can take care of all your auto body needs. Whether it is dent removal or hail damage, they can fix it. They also have a wide variety of paints to choose from for partial or full body paints. You can find us at Hettinger 103 Highway 8 South, North Dakota 58639, or call us at 701-567-4380.
Discover the Adams County Library, where adventure meets relaxation. Beyond books and movies, we offer the incredible Recreation Library, which is absolutely free to the public. Explore serene waters with kayaks and paddleboards. Enjoy quality family time with disc golf, bikes, and kites. Experience thrilling activities like tennis, pickleball, and spikeball. Unlock a world of not only recreation, but excitement here at the Adams County Library.
Attention, coaches, players, and fans. Here is a message from Nighthawk Nation.
We as Nighthawks expect you to follow these simple expectations.
Make sure to practice good sportsmanship. Please be respectful to all. Positive cheering goes a long way. And remember, we are just kids.
We all make mistakes.
To our coaches, remember to always encourage your players.
We all make mistakes, so for the players to stay focused on the game, as coaches, you should always talk positively to your players.
And remember, to relax, let the players play, and the refs ref.
To all players,
leave a positive imprint on and off the field, court, mat, and track.
Work hard, play your role, and most importantly, have fun. It's just a game.
Fans, we need to see you at our sporting events because without you, there is no excitement.
To make sure you stay at our games, please refrain from using bad language, no yelling at refs, coaches, and players.
Make your yelling positive, because you can't cheer if you're not here. So remember, be positive.
As a West River doctor, we provide care for patients of all ages, from newborns and toddlers to tweens and teens. Whether your children need routine checkups or specialized care, our experience and compassion are here to support their growth. Because even though they may be small, their health is of utmost importance. I'm a West River physician dedicated to the health of your family and our rural communities.
Hawk Talk is the official podcast of Hettinger Public School, where we keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insight to school board meetings, and dive deep into the educational experience our school provides for the students, parents, and tight-knit community. Take a minute to enjoy a clip from our most recent episode.
All right, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Hawk Talk. Today I have with me Sheriff Jordan Fisher. Jordan's been here for the last 2 years, been a heavy involvement with obviously law enforcement, but especially our school and our community, having a heavy hand on taking care of drugs in our local area. And I just want to thank Jordan for coming in and talking to us today about the services that you provide, not only in our community, but also how that affects our kids here at the school. So thank you very much for coming in.
Yeah, no, thank you for having me, Jordan. I think this is a great platform for us to be able to kind of have a different dynamic. You know, we try to get into the paper as much as we can and do some articles there and go on KNDC, but this is just another form of media that I think is just fantastic for this community to have. So thank you for having me on.
Awesome. Thank you so much, man. So the first question that I just kind of want to get out of the gate is obviously just kind of the history, you know, where you came from and how we got to here, to this current moment. But before we get here, though, you just got back from kind of some unplanned time off.
Yeah.
So what happened? What did some medical stuff, or are you doing all right?
Yeah. So it was December 19th. So just before Christmas, I ended up having to go into the hospital, have my appendix removed.
And, oh, fun. Yeah. Oh, that's so fun. Yeah.
Yeah. Being a little stubborn, I was like, man, I think I just got a little sick. You know, I have, you know, three kids. And I was like, man, maybe I just have like a little bit of a stomach bug. And no, it ended up being appendicitis. So went in and had to get that removed and doing really good now. The hospital staff, the nurses, and give a shout out to Dr. Andreas up there, the surgeon. She did an awesome job. So I'm feeling really good now. I'm back out on patrol and on duty and sitting at home for 6 weeks kind of started driving.
Yeah, it was kind of a recovery process too. You couldn't just jump back into it because there's, I'm sure, weight restrictions and the whole slew of things that you can and also cannot do.
Yeah. So yeah, it was tough, man. That 6 weeks just being, you can only watch so much Netflix, right? So
yeah, you can only keep your mind so busy. You want to go and do things. So glad to have you back. Glad to see you back in uniform and stuff. So great to have you here. So let's go into the history. So how did we get to Sheriff at Hettinger? Where did that all start? Where are you from? How did you go, you know, into this field? All of that.
Sure. So originally I'm from Bowman and lived there all the way up until I was a junior in high school. Moved down to Rapid City and lived with my dad the last 2 years of high school down there. And while I was in Rapid City, the school systems down there have what's called an SRO, or a school resource officer.
Okay.
They're an actual licensed peace officer. They work for the, you know, Rapid City Police Department, but they end up coming to the school and they're there throughout the day, Monday through Friday during normal school hours. And their job really is to, you know, make sure that kids are safe first and foremost. But they also kind of act like a counselor in a way. And so with me, going to school down there, I've always been interested in law enforcement. That was always a career path that was always interesting to me. When I was in sixth grade, I still taught to my sixth grade teacher from Bowman, and we had to write this little project about where we saw ourselves when we were grown-ups, right? And on there, I put down that I was going to play football for NDSU, and that I was going to go and I was going to be an undercover DEA agent. But I didn't play football for NDSU, and I didn't go into the DEA, but, you know.
But the trajectory is similar.
Correct. Yeah. So sixth grade, I'd say, is kind of when I started having, an interest in law enforcement.
Yep.
And I think a lot of that has to come down to Will Smith and movie Bad Boys, you know, cause I was like, man, I got to drive like a Ferrari and like, you know, I got to wear like a, you know, like Miami Vice stuff. Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every sixth grade boy's dream, man, is to drive a Ferrari around and go
oh
fast.
My gosh.
And,
yeah. Be the coolest guy on the block.
That's
of course.
It. Yeah. And so, did that and then went down to Rapid, got to really, become pretty close to my SRO. He was a really cool guy. I'd go into his office during study hall period and we would just talk about law enforcement.
Wow.
And yeah, from there he suggested that one of his really good friends was a deputy sheriff for the Pennington County Sheriff's Office. He's like, hey, if your dad will sign off on a permission slip for you, you can start going on ride-alongs on weekends. They have what's called an explorer program down there.
Okay.
And so if you're in high school, you can actually start, you know, going on ride-alongs with officers. You can hang out at the department and really see what law enforcement has to offer as far as a career. And as soon as I did that, the first ride-along that I went on, he ended up chasing a guy down and arrested him. And I was like, that's for me, man.
That was it. And you were like, I'm in.
Yeah. I mean, the guy had a bunch of meth on him and he took off on a traffic stop and he got out of the traffic stop. He took off on foot. I saw the deputy chase him down and arrest him and, pulled a whole bunch of meth off of him. And he's like, this is why we do what we do to keep this community safe. And from there, I was like, this is for me.
Now, if you enjoyed that conversation and would like to hear the rest of it, you can go and search for Hawk Talk HPS on Apple Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, and of course, our YouTube channel. Now on to the rest of our broadcast.
The HPS Stream Team is a school-to-work program in which students in grades 7 through 12 gain real-world experience while learning about the basics of live broadcasting and providing a service to our community. Now, let us take a moment to meet one of our members who help us make this possible.
Hey everybody, thank you very much for tuning in to the Streamer Spotlight, a portion where we highlight our streamers that are behind the cameras, behind the mics, behind the laptops, making these broadcasts a reality. Today we have Robert Larson in with us today. Robert, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Robert has been actually done one of these before, but it's been quite a while, so we thought we would kind of refresh it up and kind of give a new version of it. But Robert, thank you very much for coming in. For those who haven't seen one of these before, why don't you introduce yourself? You know, how old are you, your hobbies, your interests, all that stuff.
I'm Robert Larson. I am 17 years old. I am a junior currently. And some of my hobbies are, like, for example, I really enjoy just gaming. I watch a lot of YouTube, watch quite a bit of like shows and movies and especially anime. And I really enjoy video editing, which most people don't.
Gotcha.
Yep. Yeah. I find it really therapeutic for some reason. And, like, I'm a really big like music guy and I have a whole list of hobbies, just things that I enjoy.
Awesome. Fantastic. So a lot in that media realm that you're really, really interested in. And you've been on the stream team for 2 years now?
Yeah, 2 years.
Coming up on the third year this fall. So, I mean, you've been around for quite a while. What do you like about the stream team? What's some of your favorite things?
Probably my biggest thing is just like, it definitely feels like a community.
Yes, very, very much so. Where you kind of have a group of your peers that are kind of either like-minded or similar interests.
Yeah,
right?
Definitely.
Gotcha.
Because, like, you know, we have a stream team chat on Teams, and we have a serious one, but also more of a funnies one. And there is a whole culture there.
Yep, absolutely. It kind of allows the students to kind of build that bond, kind of that trust amongst each other.
Be themselves.
Absolutely. So not only with that, too, other things with the stream team that Robert's been doing, because one of the things we like to do with the Streamer Spotlight is kind of not only introduce you to who they are, but also kind of show what they've done for the program as well. And Robert's one of our stream team leaders. He has a diamond category in all three, or he has a diamond badge for all three categories, which is microphone, which is your commentating,
producer,
and
cameraman.
And cameraman. He has diamond level, which is our highest level of competency that you can reach. And by doing that, it made him a stream team leader. So Robert has not only provided a lot of good service for the stream team, but he also has new responsibilities that come with it. So whenever we make changes or policy changes to the stream team, those stream team leaders get together and they get to help decide what the future of the stream team is going to look like and how that impacts the rest of the students who are part of the program. And Robert, it's been always a helping hand and always super helpful with all that. So thank you very much, Robert, for doing that.
I'm very passionate about this.
Yeah.
It's something that I do genuinely care about.
Absolutely. And you know, another thing, and I've shared it last time, but I do have to share it again, is if another fun note for Robert is he does all the different jobs, but the main one that he does the most is commentary. And commentary for Robert, he loves to commentate the youth games. So for example, all of our elementary streams, they have typically a lower viewage, but what Robert does is he's going to take basically an elementary basketball game or whatever type of game and make it feel like it's the NBA finals for what's happening on the court. And it just makes it really fun. Sometimes it's kind of funny, but it's super engaging. So he's coming at a very high level for something that seems to be a little bit more fun. And just, it's really, really enjoyable to watch. So if you're ever bored, go into the Stream Team YouTube channel and take a look at some of the elementary streams that we've done in the past. So.
I really enjoy making the stakes unnecessarily high.
But that's what makes it fun to watch, though. That's like the cool thing, is that it adds value to the stream that you're watching, and it makes it a little bit more fun. Absolutely. Well, anywho, that's pretty much the end of our Stream Team Spotlight. Robert, any final words that you wanted to mention before we sign off?
Not much. Just thanks for watching.
Awesome.
Continue supporting the Stream Team.
Thanks.
Please and thank you.
The Hedinger Chamber of Commerce is a local business that supports other businesses in the Hedinger community. Their goal is to promote businesses and sponsor events in hope of attracting people to Hedinger while getting the community more involved. If you have questions about starting your business, an event, or want to find out more about the Chamber, contact us at 701-567-2531 or visit us at 120 South Main Street.
Dakota Western Bank, your trusting partner since 1910, serving Hedinger, North Dakota, for personal banking with checking, savings, and auto loans for businesses in agriculture. We offer tailored services and digital solutions. Discover online banking applications and mobile options. This is our website for locations, hours, and career opportunities. Dakota Western Bank, where banking meets community, proudly serving Hedinger, North Dakota.
Need a place to keep your cash safe and secure? Come on down to Dakota Plains Federal Credit Union. We can get you your cash fast with our drive-through, which is open from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., or you could come into the lobby, which is open from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. We've been serving the community since 1992, and we are located at 221 South Main Street. You can contact us at 701-567-2153.
Take the next minute to learn about some upcoming reminders and events for Hedinger Public School and the Hedinger community.
West River has been serving our community for over 40 years. Our agents are here to help you get your home, auto, farm, ranch, business, health, and crop insurance. We are located in the lower level of Dakota Western Bank. Swing by at 603 Adams Avenue or call us at 701-567-9378.
At Ag Pro Machine, we provide quality work and full-time service for ag and automotive equipment. We also have a large selection of parts and tools for your automotive and ag equipment. Call at 701-567-7500. Or you can also stop by east of Henniger along Highway 12.
Graphic Addict specializes in embroidery, screen printing, direct-to-garment printing, along with expert video and audio digitalization. Enjoy complimentary popcorn and explore over 50 flavors of delightful jelly beans when you visit. Don't miss out on gearing up for the upcoming sports seasons with our exclusive Nighthawk collection. Drop by Graphic Addict or call us at 567-3161 to discover the perfect fit for your style and needs.
Here at Kennedy's, we provide fresh goods and groceries for all your daily needs, ranging from our special selection of fruits and vegetables to our specially created delis and bakeries. Find us on 200 North Main Street or call us at 701-567-2404 to place an order.
Big deal with that subscribe button. It's not just for following our YouTube channel. It signifies much more. When you subscribe, you become a part of the HPS Stream Team, proudly supporting our vibrant program led by our students. Your subscription is a powerful statement, creating a positive ripple effect across our community and beyond. And don't forget, liking this video also sends a clear message to the students working this broadcast. It's a way to appreciate their hard work and motivates them to produce high-quality broadcasts. So, go ahead, show your support, like this video, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching!
Welcome to West River Vet Clinic. Here, we aren't just your pet's healthcare provider, we're their second family. Our awesome vets offer everything from checkups to surgery. Plus, we've got great grooming. Here, we are big on preventative care to keep your furry friends happy and healthy. We also ensure a stress-free environment for both pets and their owners. For our services, you can visit westrivervet.com. You can find us at 203 US Highway 12 East or call us at 701-567-4333.
The HPS Upload is a weekly broadcast of school news put on by the 7 through 12 video production class that provides coverage of recent events, sports, weather, and news stories. Now, let's take a look at the story from this week.
Exciting developments are underway at HPS as teachers lead a groundbreaking transformation in STEM education. With a forward-thinking approach, they've infused our school's STEM lab with state-of-the-art technology. Join me as I dive into the insights of teachers spearheading this initiative and hear firsthand from a student benefiting from these advancements.
How did we get all this of this new equipment in the STEM lab?
We asked the JCs for some money. Ms. Block and I have been writing some grants, and Mr. Siemens set aside a little bit of money that we are using for a couple of the different things that we got. So.
What are your thoughts on the new interactive board in the STEM lab?
I am very excited about it. We just bought it. We spent a lot of time picking out the one that would work the best. And I've played with it quite a bit, and I'm really excited, and I hope a lot of teachers start using it because it's pretty cool.
Have you used a 3D printer for anything lately?
Not lately because it's kind of being a stinker and I gotta get it fixed, but I've done quite a few things. We did elements with the sixth grade. The first grade made little cookie cutters, and so I'm in the middle of printing those, so all kinds of different things.
I also heard that there were Lego robotics in this classroom. What's that about?
Yes, so a couple of years ago, the school invested a lot of money in three different levels of Lego robotics. There's some for the high school, those are the black kits. The yellow kits are for my age, so like fifth grade through seventh grade, eighth grade, and then there's the little blue kits for the lower elementary to use, and they're basically an introduction to coding and robotics and stuff like that. So they have like a little motor and hub and stuff like that, and then you just design it how you want, and then you code it to do exactly what you want it to do. So they're really cool.
Is there anything else you would like to add?
We are working really hard on getting this room ready, and it definitely still looks old school and stuff like that, but it's taken a lot of hours to get this place cleaned up, and we're really excited to see where it's going to go.
Have you ever used a 3D printer?
Yes, I have.
What have you used it for?
Like 3D printing minifigures and mostly just cool stuff.
Have you ever done Lego robotics?
Yes, I have.
When did you do it?
We had to do it in sixth grade, and we just had to make things move.
How did you like all of this?
It was okay. Most of it, I liked 3D printing and the VR more. I wasn't the biggest fan of Lego robotics.
What will you be doing with VR in the classroom?
So our hope for VR is that we will eventually expand it and use it to train on our drone program. We right now are just using it to train the kids so they get used to it. Some kids have experienced it with home systems or other systems at like arcades, but most of our kids haven't seen it. So we're just getting them used to seeing what it can do, taking a look deep in the body, different places on the earth that they can go and the capabilities. And then again, soon, hopefully, we'll be able to do a virtual drone flight so we don't turn our drones into catastrophes. In real life, you can crash many times virtually with no problem.
Aside of VR, Lego robotics, and 3D printing, what other science activities happen in this classroom?
So as I said, we have a drones program that the high school is doing right now. This room is available for any use for any class K-12. They just have to sign it out. We have, like you said, 3D printing. We have electronics kits. We have microscopes. We have building opportunities for when we work with the elementary, the STEM class works with them, and we'll be making catapults and different things. So the options are pretty limitless. It's up to the creativity of the teacher.
As we conclude, let's applaud the pioneering spirit of HPS teachers in enhancing STEM education through advanced technology. Join us next time as we dive deeper into their inspiring journey of innovation.
Grand River Honey is a family-run business that's been making honey in both North and South Dakota and selling it to customers for over 30 years. We make several pounds of honey seasonally, all 100% raw and natural. This includes both clover and creamed honey. If you want some honey, call 701-567-3439, go to dakotahoney.com, or take a right after the railroad tracks on Country Club Road, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639.
Here at The Gutter, we provide a variety of food and entertainment. Make sure to enjoy bowling, pool, VR, table tennis, air hockey, and much more while we prepare your order. We have pizza, burgers, fries, dessert, drinks, and much more. You can find us by taking a left at the end of Main Street or call us at 701-567-6749.
KB Jewelers is not only a jewelry store, but they also contain a lot of other great things such as trophies, books, holiday decor, and more. When you're looking for gifts for family, friends, or if you want to look at some cool things, come on down. They're located on 206 South Main Street, Hettinger, North Dakota. You can contact them on their number, 701-567-2358. They're open from 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. from Monday to Saturday each week. Come visit.
Welcome to the Peacock Mercantile. We have been serving you since 2018. You can get baked goods like cookies, muffins, and pies. You can also get caffeinated beverages and non-caffeinated beverages. The Peacock is a nice place to socialize and meet new people. The Peacock also has refreshments like hot and cold coffee and smoothies. We are located at 213 South, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639. You can reach us at 701-637-0102. Again, that was 701-637-0102.
A better way of life is better days off and better nights in. Better hellos. And better goodbyes. With locally approved, financed, and serviced home loans, Gate City Bank makes buying a home simple. Welcome home. Gate City Bank, for a better way of life.
Does your car have some body damage? Stop by Lakeside Auto Body, where we can take care of all your auto body needs. Whether it is dent removal or hail damage, they can fix it. They also have a wide variety of paints to choose from for partial or full body paints. You can find us at Hettinger 103 Highway 8 South, North Dakota 58639, or call us at 701-567-4380.
Discover the Adams County Library, where adventure meets relaxation. Beyond books and movies, we offer the incredible Recreation Library, which is absolutely free to the public. Explore serene waters with kayaks and paddleboards. Enjoy quality family time with disc golf, bikes, and kites. Experience thrilling activities like tennis, pickleball, and spikeball. Unlock a world of not only recreation, but excitement here at the Adams County Library.
Attention, coaches, players, and fans. Here is a message from Nighthawk Nation.
We as Nighthawks expect you to follow these simple expectations.
Make sure to practice good sportsmanship. Please be respectful to all. Positive cheering goes a long way. And remember, we are just kids.
We all make mistakes.
To our coaches, remember to always encourage your players.
We all make mistakes, so for the players to stay focused on the game, as coaches, you should always talk positively to your players.
And remember, to relax, let the players play, and the refs ref.
To all players,
leave a positive imprint on and off the field, court, mat, and track.
Work hard, play your role, and most importantly, have fun. It's just a game.
Fans, we need to see you at our sporting events because without you, there is no excitement.
To make sure you stay at our games, please refrain from using bad language, no yelling at refs, coaches, and players.
Make your yelling positive because you can't cheer if you're not here. So remember, be positive.
As a West River doctor, we provide care for patients of all ages, from newborns and toddlers to tweens and teens. Whether your children need routine checkups or specialized care, our experience and compassion are here to support their growth. Because even though they may be small, their health is of utmost importance. I'm a West River physician dedicated to the health of your family and our rural communities.
Hawk Talk is the official podcast of Hettinger Public School, where we keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insider school board meetings, and dive deep into the educational experience our school provides for the students, parents, and tight-knit community. Take a minute to enjoy a clip from our most recent episode.
All right, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Hawk Talk. Today I have with me Sheriff Jordan Fisher. Jordan,
gentlemen, and welcome to the 2024 Hettinger Prom. We're going to start off with a couple of introductions here. First of all, the ushers, Eva Germanson, Sarah Holscomb, and Allison Scogan. The advisors, Kira Henderson, Anna Block, and Krista Olson. Your DJ, all the way from Airport Road, Reba Reznor. Special thank yous, and by the way, this is being uploaded on the HPS stream team. So once again, the Grand March is uploaded on the HPS stream team. We want to thank Mr. Janikowski and his team members. ProPoint Cooperative out of Bowman, North Dakota for the floor tarp. The STEM class for construction. The Methodist Church for providing a supper for our couples tonight. And all the businesses that donate to our after-prom celebration. If you would, please silence your phones. Thank you. Yep. Starting off our grand march tonight, we have Miss Layla Jensen, escorted by Malachi Dills. Miss Alyssa Martin, escorted by Blake Larson. Miss Kelly Shower, escorted by Jackson Hallen. Miss Erica Havelka, escorted by Cameron Wieland. Miss Chloe Gaumont, escorted by Christopher Kinsfodder. Miss Paige Joppa, escorted by Jalen Larson. Miss Trixie Humildy, escorted by Sam Wieland. Miss Sienna Berwick, escorted by Braden Yonner. Miss Libby Mattern, escorted by Isaac Guthrie. Miss Callie Tim, escorted by Hayden Defoe. Miss Sophia Kennedy, escorted by Maddox Pierce. Miss Gracia Jorgensen, escorted by Nathan Dix. Miss Avery Tui, escorted by Derek Carey. Miss Shay Anderson, escorted by Riley Hasbrook. Miss Brylyn Kunkel, escorted by Robert Larson. Miss Olivia Havelka, escorted by Nick Anderson. Miss Julia Daly, escorted by Landon Murphy. Miss Destiny Gozel, escorted by Logan Ebert. Miss Vanessa Ose, escorted by Braden Yonner. Miss Phoenix Pratt, escorted by Gage Goldaddy. Miss Olivia Defoe, escorted by Trace Beauchamp. Miss Tracy Seaver, escorted by Colson Melling. Thank you. Miss Gabrielle Dix, escorted by Devin Greff. Miss Jennifer Verdin, escorted by Charlie Irwin. Miss Sage Lull, escorted by Auden Richard. Miss Ellie Rosalind, escorted by Braden Motter. Miss Ella Frabel, escorted by Blaze Cathol. Miss Samantha Salazar, escorted by Chasen Schumacher. Miss Taylor Murphy, escorted by Trevor Daly. Miss Chloe Acton, escorted by Aiden Kiker. Miss Drew DeShock, escorted by Luke Holscomb. Miss Kayla Schauer, escorted by Jacob Galbraith. Miss Haley Rowe, escorted by Trinity Bohan. Miss Liesl Jacobson, escorted by Gus LaFever. Miss Avery Sanford, escorted by Gavin Aparna. Miss Maria Gertz, escorted by Micah Kilzer. Thank you for attending tonight's Grand March. We will allow about 20 minutes for pictures, and then we ask that you please leave the gymnasium. Thank you.